Latest gadgets. New tech devices for people who are blind. Presenter, Dr. Anna M. Juricic. 2014 CNIB Braille Conference.
I'm not going to show this snippet, but I have found that, you know, there's other things that are available on the market as well, like the Dyson Irobot vacuum, where you have these little robot vacuums that somebody can still have their house clean, that they can't see where the dirt is. And there is this kind of technology that is also something that could be beneficial for someone who's visually impaired and blind. And that's been developed for all of us who don't want to be vacuuming our house, if you have sight or you don't have sight. But the cost is about $1,000. Pet walks. I came across this one and I thought those who have a guide dog, how many guide dogs are in the room? There's a few, yay. So pet walk doors, it was actually revealed in London at an eco conference, and it could potentially help assist those who are visually impaired with their pets. So it's a special door insert that's now custom created in their door that has, their pet would have a kind of electronic little unit that would allow this door panel to know to open or close. So when it's time for that dog to maybe go for its walk outside or go outside for a little bit, you can even program it so it's actually predetermined that, guess what, they have to be outside for 15 minutes. So it's 3 o'clock, time for the door to go up, and they can be at the door on the other side, and you can have a program where, no, it's not 15 minutes yet, they still have to be outside, and they can come back in. But I think there's also a way, if it's bad weather, that it can sense it. But I thought it was a cute little thing. Tactile computer tablets. This is actually a company from Calgary that, I'll show you this snippet.
From our region to yours, this is AMI Calgary.
For Accessible Media, I'm Lane Fraser. With the touch of his finger, entertainer Stevie Wonder was among the first to feel the science behind a new magnetic embedded LCD screen. The singer, who is blind, was attending a conference for people with disabilities in California. According to Tactalis founder Douglas Hagedorn, Wonder was impressed.
One of the first things that he encountered when he walked into the trade show was our booth. So he spent, you know, a good 10 minutes trying out our product and getting a sense of what it feels like and what it could do. And I think he thought that there was really some strong possibilities there.
You can really feel a pulse.
It's very distinct, yeah.
The technology behind Tactalis uses magnets to help guide users with vision loss to different locations on their tablets. Using a metal stylus or ring on a finger, a strong magnetic pull is felt when different icons are touched. Hagedorn says it's part of a new...
So this is called Tactalis, T-A-C-T-A-L-I-S, and it's a tactile computer tablet. As I said, it's using magnetic technology. Yes. Well, you know what? The cool thing is that they're thinking of this kind of technology. So then somebody who otherwise would be using that tablet that's a touch screen and they can't feel it, they're able to actually know where certain icons are. So it's really at the early stages. But I thought it was interesting, and I love the fact that it's a company from Calgary. So go Canada. Future of touch screens. You're gonna see something kind of interesting. So it's showing a gentleman who is waking up in the morning. He grabs a smartphone. And all of a sudden, you're gonna see in a moment, he expands his smartphone, where it actually expands to about 4 times its size in terms of width. Yeah, this is what they're working on. But there's other interesting components to it. So they're really kind of looking, and here you can even communicate. So now they're even transmitting. Now the next scene is where touchscreen technology is transmitted onto her mirror. So she's looking at her calendar that's on her mirror as she's brushing her teeth and getting ready in the morning. And she can send a message. She's looking at the news events of what's happening. And she can send, there's an interesting article. She's going to be emailing in a moment to one of her friends. But I wanted to just kind of show you that this is what's happening. And so here's her friend. He gets the email. His screen actually, it all of a sudden kind of becomes a clear screen. On the other side at the cubicle is his friend. And what he does is able to flip around the image so the two of them are able to kind of look at the same thing. So Is this real? It may become real, yeah. But another big area is, how about driverless cars of the future? Yay.
But this is the Google car.
The Google car.
It drives itself. So really, Steve was actually more of a test driver.
This is some of the best driving I've ever done.
So a gentleman who is visually impaired said, this is some of the best driving I've ever done. He's in the Google car that's driving him.
Now I see all those new things that I didn't need before.
He's waving, you know, he doesn't have any steering wheel he has to be touching.
That's because Steve is blind, and his disability and the disabilities of millions of others is transforming the marketplace.
Yeah. So how I started off the talk in terms of the disability of individuals is really transforming the marketplace. So this is definitely a technology. It is live. He was actually having this car drive him.
CNIB. Seeing beyond vision loss. This video has been made possible thanks to an educational grant from Novartis Pharmaceuticals Canada Incorporated.